For me, it started in undergrad. I happened to take an introductory neuroscience class, and after the first lecture, I was completely in love and became a neuroscience major and kind of didn't look back. So for me, it was transformative to realize that I loved the art of science and the act of science, because it's one thing to study a subject in, you know, four walls of a classroom, right? But to do it hands-on is a completely different experience. I've had a number of undergrads come through my lab, and they can join in many capacities. So I have a student now who's going to start her senior honors thesis in the lab, so she'll really develop, you know, an entirely new project that's her own. She'll get the full arc of science, which I think is the best example of how to capitalize on undergraduate research at a place like UCSB. I've had students that join for the summer or come for a quarter or a couple quarters and get a taste of what research is like. I've even had students that, you know, didn't have the commitment or the time to officially join the lab, but they just came in for lab meetings, and even that, I think, can, you know, pull the veil off of what science is like. Because for a lot of people, it's this sort of mysterious thing, but just to make it feel, you know, very approachable, I think it has a virtue in and of itself. You know, UCSB is ranked in the top five of all colleges and universities in terms of economic diversity, financial assistance, and those are points of pride. And that diversity enriches the classroom discussions, it enriches everybody's experience. You know, I've taught at Harvard, I've taught at Berkeley, and I think at UCSB, these kids are hungry and willing to work incredibly hard. And so you leave UCSB being a citizen of the world, having foundational skills and critical thinking, and those apply to whatever profession you're going to enter and sets you up for success in any discipline, in any profession.